Hey everyone, Dan Takashi here. Oh man, this weekend, Dogecoin, cryptocurrencies, disappointing, I thought. Really disappointing. The Saturday Night Live skit, I watched a few clips and I also was reading articles. Elon Musk and what he was talking about, calling it a hustle. A good look, it's taken out of context, I understand. But just overall, the performance, I thought, given the level of excitement, was a disappointment. Yes. And it is reflecting in the cryptocurrency space big time, especially if you look at, yes, Dogecoin. Dogecoin is tanking right now. It's getting crushed right now. At one point from the highs, it was down almost 38%. Yes, and now it's at around 53 cents or so. Now, let me give you an update on what happened during the Saturday Night Live show, what other news happened for this weekend in cryptocurrencies, and of course, let me give you an update on my positions. I've been selling, especially Ethereum Classic. I was selling and I was telling everybody to sell on Friday. This has been a great trade so far. I continue to recommend this. I think that this is a little bit overbought short term. So let me give you my update on the best way for you guys to make money in your accounts. Those of you new to my channel, my name is Dan. I'm a former Wall Street trader. Would appreciate if you guys subscribe to the channel below as well as press the like button. And would also would appreciate if you press the notification button next to the subscription button as well. Thanks so much, guys, for your support every single day. I love you guys all. Today is currently 6:08 p.m. May the 9th, Tokyo, Japan time. Happy Mother's Day to everyone, every mother in the world. It's a wonderful day. I will be calling my mother later as well. Hope you guys have a wonderful Sunday as well. So now let's get started here. First and foremost, what happened with this news? Why was this such a disappointment? So there's a number of things that happened here. So Elon Musk appeared on the Saturday Night Live show. And first and foremost, guys, he called this a bit of like a what's called a hustle, and it, you know, that's just not a good thing to be calling. Like calling the digital asset a bit of basically a hustle. Look, I believe that he responded, yeah, it's a hustle. That's just not a good word to call it. Those of you who speak the English language, we know that calling something a hustle, like a hustle and a bustle, or sometimes you got to hustle to get something. You got hustled. Basically, you got swayed by something. It's kind of got a negative connotation to that. Maybe somebody took advantage of you, etc. So that was not a good thing to say regarding for the coin. Also, his explanation for when somebody asked him, "What is Dogecoin?" I know it was a skit, but it was just terrible explanation. For those of you, there were probably a lot of people who were watching that show didn't even know what Dogecoin was. And they were probably even new to it. And they wanted to know because it was such a big deal. And it wasn't explained very well. So that was also a disappointment. On top of that, Robinhood experienced an outage in its crypto trading. Probably due to all the people that were watching Dogecoin, all the people that were watching Saturday Night Live. Just it was just all and about. Everybody was focused on this. And Robinhood Help said that we're experiencing issues in crypto trading, trying to resolve as soon as possible. So that's usually not good. Right? Okay, brokerage desks, brokerage platforms, they have sometimes issues. But that on top of the Saturday Night Live skit, and people are just feeling a little bit nervous and saying, okay, now you can't really sell even if you wanted to. That's just never a good sign. Markets are very, very emotional. If you tell somebody you can't sell, that usually means they want to sell even more. So these are some of the things that I think contributed to the move down in Dogecoin. Now, let's give you an update as to what else is going on right now, especially I think right now with Ethereum Classic and looking at the charts and give you my advice on what I think you should be doing. So as usual, guys, I want to go through the charts. If you're new to investing, if you're new to crypto, if you're new to just any of this stuff, you're new to my channel, feel free to check out channel homepage. There is a playlist that's called Investing for Beginners. Check that out. Learn how to get started investing. And also, guys, check out some of the videos below, some of the broker challenge accounts that I'm also using. If you are curious on that, check out the link below as well. So let's get started here. First and foremost, guys, I want to highlight especially Ethereum Classic. Why? Because this baby has gone nuts. It was only at around $36 and it went as high as $175. Yes, this move in just a span of a few days was about 475%. Absolutely bananas. And I think the main reason was because it's just playing catch up to Ethereum, the normal Ethereum price. Ethereum normal price is around $3,930. It's making some really nice moves up. It is just continuing to go up, there's a new ETF coming in the space. I think just more and more people are getting pumped about the whole DeFi space. A lot of the technology behind DeFi is just really based on the Ethereum smart contract. So I think just continuing money flow going into that space is causing people to say, what's undervalued? tagged right now, and they're going into Ethereum Classic. However, guys, it was just overvalued. And yes, I recommended to sell this sucker, yes, on Friday, and it was wonderful. So far, I recommended to sell it. I was doing the video when it was around $150, $140, something like that. Right now, it's around $119. It's been a wonderful sell so far. I continue to think that this thing is a sell, at least short term, because if you look at the weekly RSI, it's still crazy bananas high. It went even higher than this. It's 91.92, but it was even higher at this at one point on Friday. I think it was around 93, which is, I think, close to the historical highs of June 2007. So guys, just from a technical standpoint, on a short-term perspective, it seemed like I sell. So yes, I went selling short. That's right. Why? Because I was buying other cryptocurrencies long. So this is always a hedge. It's called hedging, right? You buy some long and you buy some short. You usually want to sell something short, which is what's most overvalued. And I continue to think that this is Ethereum Classic. Looking at some of the other cryptocurrencies this weekend, look guys, the volume is not that big. So I actually don't think the selling pressure is going to be as big as I imagine. I actually thought that, look, this might tank to like under $100, and it might happen. But so far, Ethereum Classic, volume is not very big. May 9th or so. So this doesn't look to me like it's going to be crashing anytime soon. Any of these other coins I'm looking at, everything is very low here. Bitcoin volume, super low. Ethereum volume, I mean, look, the market's just open in US time. But still, it just looks very low here. Bitcoin Cash, OMG, Dash, EOS, this baby was wonderful, but I did sell some as well, and the volume's just very... Last 2 days, the volume's been extremely low, which I'm surprised, super surprised, why the volume has been so low, because I thought everybody would be watching Saturday Night Live and just be trading nonstop, trying to buy, sell cryptocurrencies. But it seems like most of it is kind of just concentrated on Dogecoin at the moment. But even this volume is big. It wasn't as big as May 5th, May 4th, the run up into Saturday Night Live. So looking at all this, you know, what am I thinking right now? What is my recommendation for what I think you should be doing with your money? Which cryptocurrencies do I still like for buying, and which one do I like for selling? Let me give you my update. As usual, guys, investing is and always will be self-responsibility. Please do note, guys, that whatever I say in my videos, it is and always will be my thought process. So take it with a grain of salt, guys. Get a lot of different opinions from different people and then make your own decisions. This is usually a good way to make any big decision, not just in investing, but also in life. Long-term, guys, I continue to recommend 70 to 90% of your net worth for a retirement portfolio. Long-term, just continue to buy stuff. It's considered a savings, right? You're not buying things. You're just allocate your savings. Yes, you want savings to go up over time. You don't want to just sit in a bank account where it just doesn't earn any interest. So that's usually where I recommend to continue and put in Bitcoin and yes, all sorts of other altcoins, all sorts of other cryptocurrencies. However, I did recommend to kind of rotate out a little bit out of, if you're holding Ethereum Classic, you're holding some of these crazy bonkers stuff that's gone up a lot, maybe rotate a little bit into Bitcoin right now, because Bitcoin right now is not really moving up. Everything else is moving up. Bitcoin's not. Right now, I believe the market cap dominance of Bitcoin is below 50%. I think it's like 45%, maybe even lower. So it's continued to go down and down. That means that Bitcoin, relative to the other altcoins right now, is undervalued. So it's a good time to rotate some of your assets from the altcoins into Bitcoin. Short term, I continue to hold this sucker short for Ethereum Classic. And I'm going to do this because my gut instincts from trading the markets for over 15 years just says that it just went up too high. I was able to sell it really well. I'm not gonna cover anything because I think this is gonna continue to go down. It's into the weekend right now. Trading is very thin. It's Mother's Day. I think it'll continue to go down into Monday, maybe even Tuesday. Let's hold this short. Let's wait until this RSI probably breaks 75, maybe even breaks 70. Then maybe start thinking about covering. I'll start thinking about covering when it gets close to $100. Then maybe after that, maybe $95. Maybe after that, $71, etc. Just cover slowly, slowly, slowly. Otherwise, other altcoins right now, short term, I don't really like anything long that much. Binance, this is looking like a breakout. this looks a little bit interesting. This does kind of look like it may continue to go up short term. All these other things right now, just short term, it seemed like they've had a really nice bump up and they're going to probably continue to go down. Dash looks like it's going to probably cross on the MACD here. EOS is probably, I know there's a system upgrade, but just there's a bit of a selling pressure here. It seems like it's trading with the other altcoins. ZEC kind of doing the same things. I don't really like these other things for short term here. Just nothing stands out to me to say, oh my God, it's going to go up immediately right now. Bitcoin chart is looking a bit interesting. I would say that looking at the most interesting charts for buy right now would probably be Bitcoin itself. Looking at this chart here, especially if it breaks 60,000, and Binance Coin. These right now have nice charts, nice momentum. Maybe buy a little bit of those and then continue to hold your short positions in Ethereum Classic or Dogecoin or any of these crazy nonsense stuff that's just gone up so much. Yes, long term, I think that there is a future for Ethereum Classic, but it's just gone up way too much, way too fast. So that's my opinion right now. Hold a hedge portfolio. Hopefully you enjoyed today's content. If you did, please press the subscription button, the like button, as well as the notification button, which is next to the subscription button as well. Thanks so much, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed today's content. I am still trying to recruit a new CFO, so see the guideline below. If you do qualify for this position, if you're interested, also send me and my staff an email below. Thanks so much, guys. Have a wonderful weekend and a wonderful Mother's Day. I will talk to you soon.